Cindy is making a necklace and using a pattern with her beads. For every 3 jade beads she puts on the necklace, she adds 10 magenta beads. If she has 9 jade beads, how many magenta beads will she need to make the necklace? Can you explain some of your thinking here and how you went through this problem?
So, I started off with kind of making the pattern so I could visually see it. And I did some multiplication to kind of find the numbers, but then I realized there was a better way in doing it.
Okay, can you explain how you started making the pattern? What made you make the decision to put circles and the squares and the number of circles and squares you used?
I made a key that says that one circle equals one jade bead.
Okay.
And a square equals magenta beads. And then I did, because it says 3 jade beads, I put 3 circles. And then it says she puts on the necklace, she adds 10 magenta beads. So I added 10 squares, and then I repeated that 3 times.
Okay. And what made you decide not to continue with this part of this way of solving the problem?
Because there is another question that said how many beads are on the necklace. And so I thought there, because I didn't really know what you call the method.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought of a thing that we do in school, which is called RICE.
Okay. So down here, it looks like you use the RICE method, and you thought that that might be better than what you were doing up here to be able to solve this follow-up question that you read. Is that why you chose to shift from solving it this way to solving it this way?
Yes.
Okay. Can you explain what you did for your RICE method? What were each of these pieces?
So the first one is read, and so I put the important details. And then the second one is for read, I underlined for every 3 jade beads she puts on the necklace, she adds 10 magenta beads, because I thought that was one of the important parts to know.
Mm-hmm. And I noticed that you did that up here, too, when you were reading it. For your first method of solving it, you also underlined these, so you were highlighting that important information when you were going through it. Very good.
And then for the second one, it's illustrate. So I did kind of the same pattern, except I made it simpler. And so instead of 1 square equaling 2 magenta beads, I did 1 square with the line equals 2 magenta beads.
Mm-hmm.
And then I just continued with the pattern.
And did you use this method with 1 square equaling 2 magenta to beads? Was that to save you some space as you were working?
Yes.
All right, good thinking.
And then for the C is calculating.
I see that says right here to calculate. Good.
Up here it says 3 jade beads she put on the necklace. And then here it says if she has 9 jade beads, how many magenta beads would she need to make? So I knew that 3 times 3 was 9.
Mm-hmm.
And then 3 times 10 using... Because I used 3 here, I would use the 3 again to multiply it by 10, and I got 30.
Okay.
And then I added that to get 39. And then for the other question, how many beads are on the necklace?
So you showed your you calculated here, and then looks like this part of RICE is the equation. Can you explain how you built up that equation?
So for the first one, it was 30 magenta beads, and then for the second one, it was 39 magenta beads and
okay.
jade beads.
So what I'm thinking is that you had 30 magenta beads and you knew that you needed the 9 more, so was this where you showed that those were added? Is that where you got the 30?
Yes.
30 and 39? Okay. Can you think about a way that you could have gotten to this solution of 39 beads with the information that you gathered here?
I could have counted by 10 for this, and then I would have gotten 30, and then I could have just added 9
mm-hmm.
to it.
And if you take a look at the work you did here, you were thinking that 3 times 3 equals 9, which is what you had done in the calculate down here, and also the 3 times 10 equals 30, So you would have arrived at 39 by doing what with these two
adding.
Products? By adding. You got it. Very good.